بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أما بعد, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, today I'm going to discuss something that is very important. It may be a bit sensitive, but it is an issue that comes over and over again through the phone calls, through the emails, and how to deal with it. So we're looking at a proactive approach, inshallah. And the issue we're talking about today is, are you ready? Yes, I'm going to say it, the mother-in-law syndrome. I know that you're smiling, I know that it's there, I know it exists, and some of you have actually gone through it, or will be going through it. So let us give you some advice, inshallah, and how to deal with it if you're in it, and how to prevent it if you're not in it. So let's say beforehand, if you're just getting married, akhi and ukhti, please make sure that you discuss this issue with your spouse. Make sure that they get to meet them. Make sure they do istishara and istikhara. Make sure that they are a good chemistry. Make sure that they have no other choice except this. But ukhti, if you agree to this, please, once you get into it, make sure that you fulfill the obligation and the commitment and the promise you've given to your husband. However, if you feel that you cannot pull your weight, ukhti, do not deceive the brother just to get out of home and certain things, and you want to leave the country and come back and do other things. We hear it all. So first thing, make sure that you're doing the right thing by doing istishara, istikhara, azm and tawakkul. All these things we'll inshallah discuss some other time. But once you commit, I want you to make sure, ukhti, to keep a couple of things in mind. One, this woman is his mother. She was his mother before he was your husband. So keep that in mind. And also, you're dealing with a human being. A human being has certain psychological influence that you have to address. First, the jealousy issue. First of all, you have to address, know for a fact that now you're sharing her son with her. Keep that in mind. Also, women are territorial. You're coming now on my domain. So once you try to change the decoration, you want to cook and you're doing this, and oh, you're replacing me, you're taking my part, this is mine, and so on. Keep that in mind, ukhti. And keep in mind, they're more mature, respect the elder, and keep in mind, if you are helping your mother-in-law or your father-in-law, it will not go in, it will not perish, ukhti. Allah will reward you in this life and hereafter, inshallah. So with that intention, it would help ease the relationship between them and make sure that you understand whatever you do will be done unto you. So if you're kind to them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have someone will be kind to you when you're in this position. But I talk to the brother now, akhi, please, if things get unbearable, you have to make a decision, but never go against the will of your parents, of course. But if you have to move out to save your marriage, I highly recommend that, akhi, but stay close to them, visit them every day, make sure that there is certain open communication, open doors, and never lose the sight of that they are your parents, first and foremost. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to mend our hearts, reconcile differences, unite us in our goal, and make us among those who listen to speech and follow the best of it. Wa akhir da'wa alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallam ala alihi wa sahbihi wa ta'ala. Jazakum Allah khairan. Assalamu alaikum.